Hey Peaches, it's Lisa, owner of Peaches Skincare. If you would like to visit us at peachesskincare.com or follow us on Instagram or Facebook, you can see a little bit more about my holistic beliefs in skincare and what I can do to help you, or we can do to help you. I am a master esthetician of over 30 years, and I have a very holistic perspective on skincare. So everything I'm teaching you is based on seeing hundreds of thousands of clients and doing really the same thing with each of them. I believe everyone has normal skin. It's what we do to it that changes it daily, weekly, monthly. And it's what we put in our bodies and what we put on our skin that really affects it and changes it. I say this all the time, but it's so important for anyone just tuning in. If you're watching me right now, I wear no foundation, no concealer, and I have done nothing invasive to my skin. I don't do Botox, I don't do fillers, nothing. Matter of fact, my skin, I just washed it. It's all clean because I'm going to show you a couple things. And if you do see anything or a flaw, that's just what's happening with my skin for that day, and I'm letting it happen. But I can honestly say, unless I'm testing something, I really don't break out anymore. If I feel wrinkly, it's usually that I'm dehydrated or I just need to baby my skin for a day or so and maybe not test something. But I thought I would show you a few things that help me to anti-age. And I really think these are valuable at any age. You know, it can be anti-acne, it can be a 20-year-old who's thinking they're already getting wrinkles on their forehead because they never wear a hat, they maybe don't even wear sunscreen and they're out in the sun all the time abusing their skin. It can be someone in their 30s and 40s that maybe went through a hard pregnancy or just went through something hard in general in life and they just stopped taking care of themselves. You know, so many of us gain weight when we stop taking care of ourselves. We stop eating properly. We have mental imbalance. And I think when we were all really on lockdown, but when we were all inside, you know, for this pandemic, and many of us are still so mindful, so many people told me their skin had never been better, but we also all gained a lot of weight because we were eating really crappy. So these are little tricks, and I have so many of them that it could fill up hours and hours of video, but I'm going to try to touch on some things that people have been asking me recently and asking what I do to help with that or make that thing or whatever it is better. And one of the things that I love is my gua sha. I don't think you need to spend a lot on this, and in fact, my gua sha was from Anthropologie. It came with a roller, but I dropped it the other day because every time I use it, I clean it, and I don't know what I did, but I dropped it on the ground and it just shattered. I think the biggest thing is making sure that it's quality, that it's not plastic, and really not paying very much for it. I want to say I paid under $20 for this, but I use it every single day. I have a video on gua sha, but a few of you just asked, and I just thought I would show you that, you know, I do my neck, I start with the blood flow here and up my chest, and then I start to roll up my neck, and I wanted to show you, people were asking about pressure. So my pressure, I would say, is pretty medium. It's not little. It's definitely not mild, but I definitely like to get into those deep muscles. And what I'm doing is I'm moving that fascia, I'm moving everything, I'm getting any knots out, I'm getting blood flowing and oxygen moving, and all of those things help to create collagen. When we lose collagen, when our cells start to die, we lose collagen. We lose elasticity, we start to sag, we start to wrinkle. And I am absolutely a believer in creating muscle memory. I believe that you can tell the brain where you want that muscle. And I can tell you that a little bit more as I show you what I do at night. But I just like to move everything and get everything going. So for those of you who asked, it is definitely a pretty strong pressure. You'll know what you like. Sometimes you'll feel a little knot and you might go over that a little bit more, but I really like to almost get into that tissue or that deep tissue and move it. I also love deep tissue massage when I can get massages. So gua sha, yes. To all of you who have asked, I do it every single night. I love it. It takes a few minutes, but with anything, your hair, your skin, It takes time and it can't be a quick fix like just going down and getting some Botox. You got to take care of your skin or covering it all up with a bunch of foundation because you don't take care of your skin. That's just not who I am. And here's the thing. If you love using foundation, if you love using concealer, remember that they are going to age you. The colors, the pigments, they will age your skin. And the skin doesn't breathe, but I like to think of it as an analogy of breathing. You're suffocating it. Also, your makeup's not going to look good if everything underneath doesn't look fabulous. Then you're just covering everything up. So remember, taking care of your skin takes some time and effort. Another thing I do is I really believe in having really white teeth. I never had to have braces. We were very poor when we were children, and I thank God for that. But I have really white teeth, and I take really good care of them. But they're also really soft, so I have to be very mindful of sugar. So a couple things that I've been testing. I tested this Hello product, and it is based on, oh my gosh, I can't even believe I can't remember that, charcoal. I can't say I saw a huge difference, and I will be honest, I didn't love how it made my toothbrush black, how it made the sink black. I'm just not really, I wasn't a fan of that, but I'm not saying this doesn't work. I also asked a couple really dear friends of mine what they thought of it when they used it, and they agreed it didn't work as well as they had hoped. I do love this other Hello product though. It's a naturally whitening, and I love how fresh my mouth feels when I brush with it. I love how fresh my teeth feel. And one thing I want to show you, because a lot of my younger people are asking, and some of my older, how to take care of your teeth. And I get that because no one ever showed me. Floss your teeth. I floss morning, I floss after breakfast, and sometimes after my other meals. You will either see a video before this or after this and what I eat in a day. I always floss in the morning and brush my teeth. I floss midday and I floss in the evening. Get in there and really get your teeth flossed and then brush your teeth. Do it slowly. Really try to be mindful. And I do use an electric toothbrush. If any of you want to know the brand, you can ask me. But I really liked this. But something that I have used before and really started getting into again was doing hydrogen peroxide. And then I keep baking soda in this little plastic container. And all I do is I dip my toothbrush or I pour a little bit of the hydrogen peroxide on my toothbrush. Then I dip my toothbrush in the baking soda. And I brush my teeth. And I have to tell you, my teeth are really very white. I used to love to use the Crest white strips, but being mindful about what I put in my body, what I put on my skin, I was really contradicting myself because there's just so much chemical in those products. So I am very mindful of that as I'm getting older, and I'm choosing not to do those now. Have I done one here and there? I suppose I would be lying to you if I didn't say I have, but I'm really trying to be more mindful and go about it more naturally. So I think keeping your teeth white, keeping in between your teeth white and clean, really helps you to look more youthful and more healthy. Okay, so that's number one. Another thing I've started doing is cleaning my tongue. Now, I always used my toothbrush, and I think I always did it about 12 times. But I got myself this tongue scraper. And if any of you want me to show you how to use it, I will. But I thought that kind of sounded gross. It was hard enough showing you how to use a neti pot. But it's an actual tongue scraper. And scraping your tongue is good for gut health, for health of your body, keeping everything clean. And I think that immediately reflects on your skin. I also, my hair. I think if you're going to have long hair at the age of 54, almost 55, going gray, I think you really have to take care of it. And I wash my hair pretty much every day. If I don't wash it for a day, I make sure to keep it up in a bun at night and off my face. But I love to use products that are masks. And I forgot the mask from Kérastase. I use one that's in kind of a peach container. And then I also started using this shea butter mask that I found at Whole Foods. And all I'll do is I'll wash my hair, I'll comb it through once I'm in the shower, And sometimes I will actually leave it on for a couple hours. It does good for my hair. My hair does well with that. I'll just leave it on for a couple hours and then I'll rinse it off. And it really helps to keep my hair thick and healthy and shiny. I don't use a lot of things on my hair. I don't use hairspray. I don't use hair gels. I only use leave-in conditioner. And if I blow dry my hair, it's very rare. It is maybe once a week, and I'll use a straightener on it as well. But I do like to use a good leave-in conditioner. A couple of you asked about masking, and that was one of the reasons I was going to wash my face as well. And I don't want to make this video too long, but I wanted to remind everyone of these masks because a lot of you are asking. So the first mask is I take bare aspirin because they're easy to crush, and I crush them in a pestle or a little grinder that grinds herbs, and I do about six aspirin. And then I add about a tablespoon of turmeric. I stir it around. I take the spoon, and you can see this in another video, and I, with the back of the spoon, put it on my face, working upward. And I make sure to do my neck and my chest as well. Everything you do to your face, neck, and chest, do to your back. A few of you have asked me to do a back facial video, and it's kind of hard for me to do it to myself. And maybe once the salon's open, I'll go show you one. But just think, whatever you're doing to your face, due to your back. I used to have a really bad back when I was young, couldn't wear pretty shirts or anything. And all I've done is taken good care of it, cleaned it, used my Persigel, made sure to mask, and it's amazing how it has. And Monistat 7. Anyone who doesn't believe Monistat 7 doesn't work, it is an antifungal and it works. So know that those are two things you can get at the drugstore that are fantastic. Monistat 7 Classic or Simple Cure, and Persigel Time Release Benzoyl Peroxide. But anyway, back to the mask. I'll crush six aspirin and some turmeric. Just know turmeric stains everything. So when I mask, I have a towel around my neck for any drippage, and many times I will actually just sit over the sink and let it do its thing. If you go sit on a couch or a chair, you really could stain things, and that stuff's not coming out. But it is an amazing mask. Another mask is oh, you know what I realized I just did, guys? Six aspirin in Manuka honey. So sorry. Six aspirin in Manuka honey, not in the turmeric. So that is the mask. The turmeric is with the Manuka honey, is a totally separate mask, okay? So the six aspirin and the Manuka honey are one mask, and the Manuka honey and turmeric are the other. And remember, Manuka honey is from New Zealand. It is very special honey. It has a special label. It has to say UMF on it. That is Manuka honey. Not just any honey works. You really want Manuka. It is healing. It is hydrating. It is anti-inflammatory, antifungal, antibacterial. It is amazing the things that this honey does. Okay, another thing at night. And Connie from Connie Still Fabulous, Connie Murphy Channel. I love Connie and Mona. Mona is an amazing lady as well. These two women have just wrapped me in their arms on YouTube. They both have such great channels. Mona will show you how to put on makeup. I'm not great at that. And Connie is just an amazing example at the age of 70. But I love to use frowny patches, and I wear one every night right between my eyes because I still want expression. I think women who use Botox look angry. They look like this whole top of their face is not moving. And many times when I look at a woman and I'm not sure what's going on, and then I realize they do Botox, I realize they look angry. They don't look as happy. So I want to be able to make those expressions. But during the night, I put on my frowny patch. I'm telling the brain for all those hours to not move that muscle. So I'm creating muscle memory. Well, Connie loves to take, and I thought I'd show you, she'll take some surgical tape and she will, I hope I'm doing this right, Connie. She'll just cut it, and I'm gonna actually make it a little smaller, and I'm gonna do two pieces. And she actually says she'll wear them under her glasses during the day as well. And on clean skin, you can just take the tape, put it over your 11s, and I like to rub, get blood flowing there. And then go over your other side, and you can simply do that at night. I tried it a couple times. I thought it worked well. I've never had skin irritation from this. And I will be honest, I've only done this for about a week, so I haven't noticed any skin irritation, maybe not as much. So please make sure that if you notice any skin irritation, that you are aware of that. And I think all of you know by now, I know no one does this, no one tells you to do it. I've had people tell me, I don't know, milk and magnesia. 35 years I've used milk and magnesia on my face. Shake it up. Gets nice and thick around the top. Only I use this bottle and my husband. I put it on my face. I work up on my face every single night. If you use things like hydroquinone, Retin A at night, if you feel like the milk of magnesia burns, let me know. I've had a few people say that. I have no issues with my retinol, but it's also not synthetic. But I put the milk of magnesia on, I work up on my lines, my face, and I let it dry while I'm reading a book, and I have no crepey skin. I wake up with no acne. If I'm broken out, if I'm testing products, I put milk of magnesia on it. It's anti-inflammatory. It helps to bring down any redness. They use it in the hospital on diaper rash, on bed sores. So milk of magnesia is a friendly product, and it's an over-the-counter product, and you don't need to spend, you know, a bunch of money on some special mask. I do love Miracle Mask though, however. I think it's really important to keep your body and your skin clean. I don't believe in over or peeling your face or your body, but I do believe in body scrubbing, getting that callus layer off. And I always use a body scrub in the shower. This is my favorite. It's by Pure Fiji. I've showed it to you before. I love this product. We just get it on Amazon. We used to sell it, but quite honestly, I don't like to keep them on the shelves too long, and it's wonderful. And I use it every single night on my body to just keep my skin feeling good, looking soft. And I wanted to show a few of you this. You were all talking about arthritis and pain. I don't know if any of you know about Salon Paws, but I use these. I am bone on bone on my left toe, and I put this on my feet. My son also has a disability where it affects his feet, and these are natural and amazing to help with pain, and they're just incredible. It has nothing to do with anti-aging, but as we age, we do have issues. You know I love my new face. Nothing beats professional microcurrent. I want you all to be incredibly mindful about the different machines that different people are recommending to you. You're all overdoing stuff. You're overdoing so much. Microneedling to where you're bleeding. I've read so many articles on that, and I've seen visually so much damage from that. Make sure you're getting this done in an office with a master esthetician or a doctor. And really, in California and Ohio, we're not allowed to touch the face like that. So I would never microneedle someone. Do I believe that the wounds end up making more collagen? I actually think you're breaking down your collagen. You're actually aging your face, and there are studies that show you can really make your skin more susceptible to skin diseases. And I believe when that happens, more susceptible to skin cancer. But that's my holistic opinion. I love this little new face guy. It's great. And then get professional microcurrent in the salon. So important. What's done before and after. And lastly, a lot of you are asking me about sunscreen. You're sending me pictures, you're sending me types. I can't recommend something if I haven't used it for at least 3 to 4 months. I just won't do it. And a good example is the fact, I guess I should take these off now. Oh, I'll leave them on. A good example is the fact that I just tested some sunscreen and it really broke me out because they didn't have their full ingredients list. I'm no longer recommending EltaMD. They have gone from just a zinc oxide to adding chemical sunscreen, and I can't recommend it. So use up your bottles and let's get rid of the Elta MD. I used to love this product, but I'm just really disappointed that they had to add chemicals to their sunscreen. So this is a no-go for me. I'm loving this Color Science Glow. I purchased this myself. This is not something they sent me. I'm going to try a few more of their products, but I'm not breaking out. It does have a little iron oxide color to it, and I'm okay with that because I don't put a lot on and I don't try covering anything. I purely use it if I'm going to be outside in the sun, and I wear a wide-brimmed hat. You have got to wear a wide-brimmed hat. You know I'm not an advocate of sunscreen. I think we're overdoing it. We got to be mindful with that. But I did a whole video on that. And then I just started testing this little mineral stick sunscreen from Trader Joe's. I don't like sticks because I don't want you to touch your face and then put it back in. But what I'm doing is I'm only using it on myself, and I'm kind of taking off some of the top and then using it again. And so far, so good. But just look for things that are zinc oxide only, have no fragrance, and are reef safe. It's so important that it's reef safe. But again, if you're not wearing a hat, no sunscreen's going to matter. I don't care what anyone says. And you can keep applying it and doing all of that to your skin, but again, I do a whole video on that, but you've got to wear a hat. So I hope these were a few things. I guess you could call them my favorites, but just more things that help you to feel younger, more healthy, more anti-aged, more anti-acne at any age. I wish so much I could implore you when you're in your teens and your 20s to start an active, healthy lifestyle, to take care of your skin, to take care of your body. And then into your 30s and 40s, skip the Botox, skip all that junk, and just take care of your skin naturally. Hope you enjoyed this video. Comment with love below. And I would be incredibly grateful if you would subscribe. So many of you are watching, but you're not subscribing. It's so important for me to get my really unique and different beliefs out there on YouTube, because I am an anomaly and I want to help more people stay beautiful naturally.